Hello.
I thought I'd do a video because I'm in the middle of a streaming
I was right.
For some reason it just didn't sound right. Anyway, I'm doing this video because a few people have asked what kit I'm currently using and where I am in regards to my streaming equipment journey. The reason I say that is anyone that's done this or started this will understand how addictive this actually is. It's not necessarily this part, it's behind you as well. I mean, this changes every time I go live. There's always something different. Very important for the golfers out there, this needs to be shown. Obviously the golf bag and the guests, the dog beds. And for anyone that's unaware, my dad actually made this. It's pretty cool. This is my own custom bar. So this is a kegerator inside. I would lift it up, but there's so much crap on here, it's ridiculous. Own little tap for an owl beer at some point. Lemetrics tells you stats of everything that we're doing socially. I'm obsessed with Japanese whiskey and Irish. A signed Alice Cooper and the gang owl head cover. President's Cup, the last time I saw Tiger. But this whole thing starts off very small. It's just little bits of kit, and then you start scouting Amazon, all the local computer stores. And it just keeps building up. And like, some of the things that turn up, I'm just like, I can't remember ordering that. Well, I can, but I pretend I couldn't. How did that get here? So basically, this is my streaming view. This is pre, I don't know, gaming PC, I suppose. So we're using the Series X, which my other half kindly got me for Christmas. Elite controller, which is meant to make you better at Call of Duty, but I'm pretty sure I'm worse. I ended up getting a primary Samsung monitor. I put the proper specs down below. With that, we've got a secondary, which I usually put on the side on the tilt for chat and all the other Twitch stream management bits. So I'm running the entire stream. Oh, actually, speakers. Let me listen to this. Obviously, it's not going to sound great through this. I'm using the inbuilt camera microphone, but honestly, especially at night with the RGB lights flashing, that's another addiction, by the way, RGB lights. Once you start there, you want everything to be flashing. It's like it's going to be a bit like a disco in here. And then we get to this thing. This, I mean, you can probably hear it, listen. It's crying, it's actually crying. I'm running the entire stream. I've got speakers, I've got both monitors, the actual Elgato light, which is fantastic, by the way, we'll get to that in a second. But this whole thing is being run on a Mac. Keep telling the missus as well. I'm like, this streaming thing's getting more and more serious. But it's good for editing YouTube videos as well, obviously. So for everyone that cares, the mic is a Blue Yeti. This thing's fantastic. And this arm was just cheap. Super to, you know, maneuver around. So this is my Elgato Stream Deck, which isn't necessary. There is an app now, which I think costs peanuts a month. But this is just cool for visual as well. I mean, each button does a different scene. You can set up different, you know, camera angles, ads, clips, light. So we'll go to the light here, look. Change the brightness by changing these buttons. And then these are different colors. So we go cool, neutral, or warm. Like I say, it never stops. I got everything at basic, and then it's like a set of golf clubs, for example. You start upgrading little bits. So I have many ideas for the stream, but you've just got to be careful. You end up spending thousands and thousands of dollars when people ask you what do you actually need to stream, and honestly, the bare minimum. Xbox, for example, when I first started, it wasn't even the Series X, it was the Xbox One, and I just used an old webcam, which I still use to this day. So for anyone that wants to get started, you know, I'd say go audio first before you improve your webcam. Get something like this, because that makes a humongous difference for everyone listening. And what you've got to realize is not everyone's watching all the time on Twitch. So audio, they could have it on in the background, and audio is like the main source. So you just got to, I reckon that's the biggest. And then visuals, second. Lighting has made the biggest difference for the webcam. It would have been so easy to just stick a DSLR there, but I basically tried to make it as good as possible with a light, and then I will eventually move to a DSLR. and that's just to get manual exposure, obviously depth of field as well. So it looks pretty good. So guys, just a little peek into the setup here. I'll put more information down below, the links to where you can get this sort of stuff. They are affiliate links, so I will get a cut. Thank you. But like I say, to get started, don't fall into the trap of buying like this. You don't need stuff like this. There's an app for that. I mean, you don't even need the app. You can just run it straight off of basically your Mac to start with. You don't need this sort of stuff, but it's so hard to stop once you've started, I warn you. But if you have any questions of the equipment I'm using, stick them down below. I would love to hear from you all. Thank you for this channel. It is a new one, obviously, for everyone that watches the Golf Channel. That's established itself. This is brand new. It's been a great little refreshing journey to start something again. And it's well out of my comfort zone, but I'm loving it, if I'm honest. It works very well with Twitch. TML community's on fire with the Discord. If you're not a part of that, again, somewhere down there it'll be, I think. Thanks, guys!